Shiny is saying start. Are we starting?
자, 준비가 된 것 같습니다. 자, 경기 네오제이드고요. 네오제이드 경기 순서 가보도록 하겠습니다.
Go go go.
아프리카 스타크래프트 대전시 소닉TV와 함께하고 있습니다. 7차 스타비제 리그 16강의 두 선수 B조 경기 네 번째 경기고요. 맵은 제이드입니다. 자, 경기 한번 바라보도록 하죠.
Hana, Tool, Se, Saber fighting! Alright, we're started. So, set 1 on Neo Jade. I think the maps are gonna be the same for all the sets or something like that. Anyway, in the bottom right, as the yellow Terran, the Hulk Terran himself, the man who is 202 centimeters tall. That's like 6 foot something for you silly American people. It is Shiny, who I believe is a former Sonic Starlight champion. He didn't do so well in the last one, but he, according to Mr. KJWCJ, he won like the third or fourth Starlight. And there, on the left side, is the lovely Saber. There you go. Nope. There you go. Saber versus Hulk toss. Or Hulk turn, rather. Whoops. Man, I wonder how many like keyboards and mice he breaks while laddering. You know? Because like normal nerds, you know when they get mad sometimes like they punch the keyboard. Like, you know, like when Idra famously punched the keyboard at an MLG or something, he just popped out his F11 key or some shit. See, that's what happens when like, you know, silly little nerds punch their keyboards. But when that guy punches his keyboard, I bet like a hole goes through his table or something. So he probably has to buy a new table every time he rages in ladder. Anyway, there's Saber at the top right as the red Zerg. Going for a overpool, looks like. Interesting, going for overpool DVT. On the other hand, Shiny's actually doing something interesting as well, going for a gas, so going for some kind of tech play here. Let's actually see what happens. We did see a couple of interesting tech builds on this map from Lita in Pro League last season, but KJW is saying that it's more likely going to be a 2-port Wraith. Oh! Still taking inspiration from Lita, in fact. Saber, on the other hand, I actually read good things about Saber in the Team Liquid preview for this SSL Sonic Star League round of 16. For anyone who doesn't know, there was actually a really nice preview article they've written. Team Liquid is actually covering this league as well, somewhat in a similar way that they did for OSL or MSL. So apparently he's kind of a newcomer to the Afrika scene, but you know, I mean, he was number one in his group in the round of 32. And has been showing some pretty sweet play so far. Meanwhile, it looks like the SD scout of Shiny luckily went in the correct direction, so he's seeing the Lings incoming here. He's got two Marines, he's going to probably pull a couple more SCVs here to help block the ramp. As long as he's got a couple of SCVs on hold position at the top of the ramp with the Marines behind, he should be absolutely fine against these Zerglings. The SCVs having a lot of HP there to buffer. So let's see if Saber tries to go for something. Might try and focus down one of the SCVs and run in, but no, it looks like deciding that actually doesn't quite have enough here. Oh, man, Shiny's really tempting him there, like, come on, bring it, Zerglings, bring it. Anyway, we do have one starport here, and gas still being mined. I don't see a second SCV going out, excuse me, to build another starport yet. So it could still be some kind of weird vulture drop, but we shall see. On the other hand, 3 hatchery, follow up for Mr. Saber. Who's just going to pull back with the Zerglings now? He's going to be a little bit careful. Oh, looks like trying to run around two Zerglings to try and hide on the side and sneak in later, but doesn't quite manage it. Actually, he might have just sacrificed those two Zerglings so the rest of them could get away. Of course, if he just ran all his Zerglings back, the Vulture would have easily run them all down, but instead he sacrificed two Zerglings, sent them the other way, and so the Vulture pulled back to kill those two, so his other two Zerglings actually got away home free. So that's actually quite a cute little move there. Meanwhile, Sun Colony is finished here. Unfortunately for him, he didn't build the third hatchery in a way that kind of sim cities and blocks this vulture from running by. So there's an opportunity for this vulture to run by, but he's going to leave his Zerglings there to help out. And of course, the natural here is a little bit narrow on Jade, so it's not the biggest deal in the world. Meanwhile, the machine shop is spinning. Is only one starport, so I think this is going to be a vulture drop with mines here. Kind of the beginnings of the fantasy build. So he's going to make one Wraith first, that's also very standard. Go one Wraith, then get your control tower, get a dropship, and do your Vulture drop. Meanwhile, Lair is going up for Saber. Now, Saber, seeing this Vulture, knows that it's some kind of tech play, obviously, but there are many different possibilities. A one Vulture just into expansion is fine, going for two port is fine, going for Vulture drop is also fine. I've even seen like one port cloak Wraith rather than two port, which is quite weird. But look at this! Saber actually suddenly building a whole bunch of Zerglings here, wants to go do something. The Vultures are you know, as part of the build, the Vultures are supposed to kind of keep the Zerglings away from the Terran here. Of course, with good patrol micro, you can take out almost infinite numbers of Zerglings with Vultures here, so they're supposed to give the Terran map control, but it looks like, oh man, one of the Vultures is going to get trapped by these Speedlings, and the Speedlings are moving in here. There are a couple of mines in position, but are they going to get dragged in? No, not quite, and now closing with the Marines. The bunker's not finished yet. The bunker does finish, but it looks like the Marines are not going in the bunker. The Marines don't go in the bunker! Oh my god, a huge mistake there from Shiny. I don't know what just happened there, if it was a misclick or something, or if he spammed. I really don't understand why at least one of the Marines didn't go in the bunker there. They just both stood next to the bunker when it was finished. At the end, only the SCV went into the bunker, bizarrely. Now the thing is, with all these Vultures, he's still going to be okay, of course. But that was really, really strange. I don't understand. He's going to have to rebuild a few Marines now, when he would have rather just built his command center straight away. The Wraith, meanwhile, also going to go in and do some damage here. I don't know what anti-air Saber has. Looks like he has gone for a Hydro Den here. No Spires, so perhaps going to go for some Lurk or follow-up here. I guess we shall see. I don't really think that would be the best idea, though, with all these Spider Mods on the map. Probably better to just get a Spire and then just go go get some Mutas here. Yeah, that's what he's doing. Getting a slightly later Spire. And gonna get some Mutas as a pretty standard follow-up, so very, very interesting stuff. Meanwhile though, we still haven't really seen that starport put into use besides making that Wraith. Ah, there's the dropship. I was gonna say, I was wondering where that was. Finally the dropship comes out, and gonna drop those in, but I mean, Saber should be aware that this is a very real possibility here, so I think I saw a Hydra move up there into the main just now. I'm not really sure. Does he have a Hydra there? He's got one Hydra in the main. These Vultures don't actually have Spider Mines anymore, I think. They've all used their mines. They do have speed, though, so they're going to be able to kill a handful of drones here. It looks like five drones killed so far. Going to get a sixth drone there and just kind of chill behind the spawning pool. Hide behind the overlay there, get a few more Zergling kills before the Hydras come back. But see, these are unupgraded Hydras, so actually the Vulture is going to do a lot of damage here. Six and seven, eight drones now dead, I believe. Actually, nine drones, I think. 10 drones, 11 drones, 12. Oh, it doesn't quite get the last shot off there. So I believe that was 11 drones killed, which is pretty huge at this early point in the game here. And you know, also because Saber went for that early Ling attack, and I don't think did that much damage. I mean, he killed all the Marines, he killed a couple of Vultures, but didn't really get into the main and do any significant economic damage. So, you know, committing a lot of the early larva to Zerglings and then losing a bunch of drones, his economy is really not in a happy place right now. However, his Spire is done, so he's going to build some Mutas. Let's see what he can do with that. So I'm going to move out his Slow Overlords here to try and help clear some of these Spider Mines. Of course, there's a Spider Mine built for the 12, or sorry, not built, but placed at the 12 o'clock to deny the Zerg's third base. And I like this positioning. A couple of Scourge here to try and snipe off whatever pops out from that starport. Little does he know, he can actually run over and just kill that Wraith on the side. Meanwhile, one Vulture somehow has actually managed to come back into the main. I guess it was ferried in by the dropship again, but it's going to get denied. It does have two kills, and oh, going to get taken out by the Sunken. Looks like the Scourge didn't seem to do anything there, going to get warded away. But the Zerg's still unable to take a third base here, and the Terran's happily mining from his natural, so, you know, Saber really wants to think about taking a third base fairly soon, and there's no good way for him to do it. I mean, you know, the 12 o'clock is blocked by the Spider Mine. To take a further away one is a bit risky with Vultures and Wraiths running around on the map. And now the Cloak Wraiths are coming in to do some harassment here. I'm going to kill even more drones. Oh, this is just so painful for Saber. He's been on the back foot this entire game. There's a couple of Hydras now coming in to help defend this, but again, they do look like... Are they slow Hydras still? It looks like there's still slow hydras, in fact. So that's really not going to be helpful for defending. Meanwhile, looks like we have siege tank coming out. I think an armory was being built, so that will allow him to build Goliaths and or Valkyries if he needs those to defend against any incoming Mutas. But kept up the rate reduction, which is kind of interesting. He's still got just one of every building, so I still don't actually know what his transition is going to be. Presumably he's just going to build a bunch of I'm sorry, that was Academy, not an Armory. Okay, never mind. Okay, so now, yeah, so he's definitely going to go back into pure into bio here. He's going to add on a bunch of barracks fairly soon, I'd imagine. Yeah, there we go. There's a bunch of barracks. So now it's pretty clear, and nice move by Saber there, though, to use the Scourge to check out what's going on. So he knows also that it is just going to be bio coming at him soon, so he can play a more standard game. Looks like Drone trying to figure out what it's trying to do here. He should be making a 30 with that at the main base. So despite the somewhat unorthodox opening, we are going to have a fairly standard mid and late game. A few lurkers coming out. They have to be very careful not to get too close and get taken out by the spider mines. The raids, meanwhile, is going to pick off what they can. It's going to kill a few free overlords here and there. It's exactly what they should be doing. No point being overly aggressive with them. Just get what you can. You know, deny the nice, deny all the overlords on the map that would be providing zero vision. And whoa! Wait, what? Did they hit different rates? Wow. That's interesting. I wonder. The thing is, I don't even know if that's intentional or not, because now the rates have like 10 HP each. So a Hydra could just kill them in one shot, basically. Actually, no, I think they have armor, so it'll take two shots now. But yeah, he's got a few Hydras out, so maybe he just wanted to weaken them up. I'm pretty sure that was a mistake, though. I think he just kind of... Oh, you might get it probably this time? Oh, nice cloak. Oh, his micro's not perfect, but yeah, he's gonna get it anyway. And going back into Medic Marine. He's still producing Sea Shanks though, which is interesting. So he's not going the SK Terran style pure bio plus science vessel. So he's getting a few Sea Shanks to help out his mid game army. And actually, look at this. The Zerg's taking a hidden third at the bottom left main instead of taking the top left. Was that what that drone was doing earlier? I wasn't actually paying attention to where it was on the minimap. I just assumed it was at the top left. It's possible it was there in the first place. But here we go, a big attack actually coming in from Saber, looks like. He's going to be very, very careful about these spawn mines. Now he's just going to leave the lurks out here in front. And oh, spotted. Completely busted. Oh, and he's waiting for it to finish! Oh my god, he's going to wait for it to finish so it can't even be cancelled! Oh man, that's a great move by Shiny there. Look at that. Oh, that's dirty. I can't believe that Marine at the top left isn't even shooting it like just by default. It looks like it's in range, but I guess it's not. And oh, I just see it. So he's gonna immediately cancel that. I don't know how he saw that there, but I guess he must have seen the dropship move out earlier or something. That's some pretty crazy game sense or something. But yeah. Huh. Anyway, looks like Scourge is not going to do too much there. And the Terran army is moving out. Some semi-lurker contained earlier, it looks like, didn't hold off the Terran for too long there. Bit of a mistake there, losing one of his vessels for free, but the attack is coming, and there's only a handful of lurkers here. It looks like actually Saber just making more sunken colonies to help hold this off. His defiler map is finished, so he just needs to buy some time for his defiler to get out, but he's getting his lurkers irradiated here, and I don't know if he has enough time actually for these defilers. He has built a good number of sunken colonies, but it looks like he GG out. Was that a GG? Wait. What the? What's going on? Did he type GG and I didn't see it? Oh man. Alright. GG! I guess he typed it and I just didn't notice. No, we saw him type it on the camera. So they like cut to the camera before he typed GG in the game, and then he typed GG, and they didn't go back to the game. Alright, so Shiny takes game one. With a somewhat awkward ending. And we're going on to game two.
경기 바로 이어가 보도록 하겠습니다, 여러분들.
에이. Back to the game.